Welcome to Engineer on Python. This is a Python programming course for engineers. In this video, I will talk about how to use SymPy for statistics and complex number computation. We can use SymPy to create some commonly seen objects. Before we start, let's first import SymPy and SymPy stats into our own program. Then we turn on the pretty printing mode. Now we create two six-sided dice, X and Y. They are objects created using the die class. This statement will show the probability density function of x as a dictionary. When we throw the die x, there is a 1/6 probability that it will show 1 point on top. There is a 1/6 probability that it will show 2 points on top, and so on. The sample function will take a sample from this distribution. It means we roll the die x and observe what the value on top is. In this case, its value is 5. We roll another die, y, and observe, it's 3. The capital letter P is a probability function. The probability that x value is greater than 3 is a half, or 50%. It can be either greater than 3, or less than or equal to 3, with equal probability. The capital letter E is the expectation function. The expected value of x plus y is 7. This is because, for each die, the values can be 1 through 6, so the expected value is 3.5. For the sum of two dice, this is 3.5 plus 3.5, which is 7. The variance of x plus y is 35 over 6. We can also create a coin with the coin class. A coin has two sides, heads and tails. We show the probability density function of this coin using a dictionary. The probability that its heads is 1/2 or 50%. The probability that its tails is another 50%. Next, we create a random variable z that follows the standard normal distribution. The class name we use is normal. The random variable name is a string z. The mean is 0 and the standard deviation is 1. The probability that z is greater than 1 is about 15.8%. It's represented by the shaded area in the image. Here we create a random variable that follows the Bernoulli distribution. The class name we use is Bernoulli. The random variable name is a variable v. Another argument is 0.75. The probability density function of V is shown here as a dictionary. There is a 75% chance that the variable will be 1, and 25% chance that the variable will be 0. This probability density function is also shown in this image. Let's take a few samples. For the first three samples, the values are 1. For the last sample, the value is 0. SymPy can deal with complex numbers. A complex number consists of the real part and the imaginary part. The imaginary part is represented by a real number times this I, which is the square root of negative 1. So I squared is equal to negative 1. In SymPy, it is denoted by this capital letter I. It's case sensitive and must be in the uppercase. The output in Jupyter, however, is always in the lower case. I squared is equal to negative 1. Let's solve this equation. X squared plus 1 equals 0. There are two imaginary roots, negative I and positive I. Now let's create a complex number z. Its real part is 4. The imaginary part is 3 times I. Note that this must be a capital letter I. The function re will return the real part of z, it's 4. The function im will return the imaginary part of z, it's 3. The absolute value of z is equal to the square root of the real part squared plus the imaginary part squared. So for z, it's the square root of 4 squared plus 3 squared. The result is 5. The conjugate of a complex number a plus bi is equal to a minus bi. So for z, it's 4 minus 3i. Finally, I would remind you that it's better to avoid using these capital single letters E, I, N, O, P, and S to name your own variables because they are used for special purposes in SymPy. E is the base of the natural logarithm in SymPy, and it's used for expectation in SymPy.stats. I is the unit imaginary number. N is a numeric approximation function. O is used for the big O notation in Taylor series. P is a probability function. S is a SymPy function. Okay, that was how to use SymPy for statistics and complex number computation. The course materials are available on YouTube and GitHub. You can watch the course videos in sequence. If you like this video, please subscribe and share. I'm Yong Wang. Thanks for watching.